Hey, I'm Brennan with RevZilla, and today on Ride Tested, we are checking out the Roland Sands Clash Jacket. So without further ado, let's hop aboard the Triumph, take a closer look. So the Clash Jacket, this has been around for quite some time within Roland Sands line. I definitely think it's one of their staples, along with the Ronin. And I absolutely love this jacket. I mean, from a style perspective, it looks really sharp. I haven't seen it on anyone where it doesn't look really good, but it's not the cheapest jacket, that's for sure, especially when you consider that there's not a whole lot of features and versatility with this jacket. So just know that you're paying for the style, and sometimes that's okay. I buy stuff just because it looks cool all the time. Are you kidding me? That's part of riding motorcycles. That's the whole reason I got into riding motorcycles, because I thought they looked cool, and they are cool, and I would be cooler by riding them because I'm actually a giant dork. So follow your heart, all right? Now, if you do decide to look at this jacket, just keep in mind there's three different flavors of the Roland Sands Clash jacket. So I've got the standard Clash, there is the signature Clash, and then there is the CE version. Each of them are a little different. The Clash jacket, you've got a cowhide leather main construction, of course, and then you've got Roland Sands armor. It's CE level 1 protection. I do love this jacket. It is very comfortable. I went with a size small because I'm right there on the border between a medium and a small. And if it's a little bit more on the boxy side than I would have pictured for Roland Sands, knowing it's a bit more of a Euro stylish cafe racer design, but it does fit a little bit more boxy. So I went with a small. I'm really glad I did, because this leather breaks in with regular use and time, as typical leather does. So I would say if you're in between sizes, go with a smaller option. If you don't plan to add any layers underneath or anything like that, and knowing I didn't need to, I just wanted a nice snug fit. The small was perfect for me with a 38 and a half inch chest. So just something to keep in mind there. And speaking of layers and comfort and things like that, this isn't going to be the best option for the middle of summer, depending on your region, nor will it be the best option in the winter as well. So there is a kind of a window that this jacket is going to work well for most people. Today, now the high today, I think, is about 73 or so. It's probably about 65 at this very moment. I'm comfy as can be in a t-shirt, and I'm doing about 55 right now, just cruising along. There's no ventilation, so primetime summer, this thing is gonna get real nice and toasty. So just something to keep in mind there. And in the winter, leather just isn't really the best option, because once that leather gets cold, it's just cold, you know, and it becomes a little bit stiff. Textile, you know, with a waterproof exterior is probably gonna be your best option for the winter. You can certainly use this in the winter if you wanted to, but I wouldn't recommend it. I'll probably push it down into some colder temperatures and throw on a little thermal underneath, maybe, if I know that I'm not expecting rain or anything like that. But it's certainly better suited for the spring, fall, and maybe some of the summer, just depending on where you ride. If you're not in the city and you're not in stop and go traffic like I am on a routine basis here in Philadelphia, then you'll probably be okay. Overall, very simplistic. I love the asymmetrical zipper on the chest. I'm a big fan of the asymmetry. I have a Speedy jacket, has similar asymmetry kind of design going across it. I wear it all the time in the ride tested videos. Love that one as well. So I love this design. You've got magnets up here at the top. So if you wanted to pin back the collar, open it up a bit, you can certainly do so. And those magnets will kind of keep it in place. But from a feature standpoint, really, there's not a whole lot going on with this. You've got some accordion, you know, you've got a very simple interior. So it's a very straightforward jacket. The leather is nice and thick. It's built to last. This is something that is very timeless as well, and it's gonna work on a variety of different motorcycles. You know, whether you're on a Ducati Monster, a Triumph Thruxton like this right here, you know, an R6 even, it might feel a little restrictive, but once you break it in, if you're riding on an R6 on a routine basis, it's gonna break in to that riding position and have some give and additional comfort for you. So just something to think about. It's simplistic. You're paying for the style. Just know that going into it. From a features perspective, it is very simple, but excellent abrasion resistance with this. You've got some impact protection, so not all is lost. Anyways, I'm gonna get back to riding. Actually, I should go by the Rocky. statue here and chase down this Ducati Scrambler that I just passed. But guys, I hope you get out there on the road, get in some riding time, stay safe out there, and as always, keep it pinned.